How to get noticed by college recruiters and college scouts. First thing I'm going to tell you is you need to look at the measurables. You need to look at Perfect Game, PBR, Prospect Wire. You need to look at Baseball Northwest for you in the Northwest. You need to look at Pac Northwest. You need to look at some variables about who you are as an athlete. Meaning, what's your exit velocity? What is your bat speed? What is your arm strength? What's your 60-yard dash time? If you're, for example, a sophomore in high school or junior in high school, and your exit velocity is 85, and you throw 75 miles an hour, and you run a 7.860, do not go to the showcase until you get those numbers up. I have seen on Twitter the last few days, I don't spend a lot of time on Twitter, but I just had this hunch of like just looking at college placement videos. And if you attend, for example, a PBR event, and you take the 10 same swings that the other 100 kids are signed up for that video, take the same 10 swings off of lobbing BP, and then you get 5 ground balls thrown to you, and you expect to stand out, like it's not happening. You need to get creative with your videos. I talk to college coaches almost every single day of my life, and they want to see something different, not the standard typical video. You need to update it. Every couple weeks, you need to send new video footage. And you need to look at the top players in your area, in the country, and say, where do I stand with that? Where do I stand with my 60-yard dash? Where do I stand with my velocity? Where do I stand with how hard I throw a ball or how hard I hit a ball? Because you can't put average statistics out there. It hurts you more than it helps you. I need everybody to understand this. Parents, please listen to me. Don't just go to these events to go to these events. Look at the events, look at the numbers, get testing, go to a facility that has these measurables to see where you're at before you attend these events. If you're in the bottom third or the bottom half, don't go. Get better at those things before you go. I try to tell my parents and players this all the time, is make sure you will stand out. Don't be like 1,000 other players around the country. Do a variety of skill video. Do live BP, do base running, do some fancy infield stuff. But if you think taking 10 law BP hits, and if you think getting 10 regular ground balls is gonna make you stand out, it's not, okay? And so I just share this video to hopefully help people understand. If you've done these videos and you posted on Twitter, get off of them. If you've done these videos and you've posted them to college coaches, get them off of them, because they're putting delete, 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 delete. But if you're an infielder and you can do a backhand, sliding backhand with a full baseball uniform and make a play, right? If you can do something to look different, if you can show a drag bunt, if you can drive a ball to the opposite field, if you can show you actually hitting a home run, all these types of things will help to get you noticed. And I talk to college coaches all the time, and I need you to understand this. Don't do the typical video. Video footage can be very, very detrimental to actually you playing college baseball. Because if you send an average video with average bat speed and average arm strength and average everything, you become average and no one's interested in you. And so this video is to give you kind of a direction and hope to understand, like do something different. And if you're not quite sure, do a little bit of research of some really good videos and ask some people what they think of it. But most importantly is get some measurables to see what you stand for your grade class, for your size, for your strength, for your exit velocity, arm strength, all that kind of good stuff. So hope this helps you. Hope this gives you some direction in the right way, and God bless you and take care.